that beautiful anthem this morning. Our scripture reading today comes from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. The scripture reads, "We know that all possess knowledge. Knowledge puffs up, but love builds up. Anyone who claims to know something does not yet have the necessary knowledge. But anyone who knows God and loves God is known by Him." May God add His blessing to the reading of this word. I love this verse. Knowledge puffs up, but love builds up. I love it because it takes something that we all value. Knowledge, wisdom, education. These things we know are important, and they are very important to our lives, but it still puts them in the backseat to what is most important, and that is love. Love is the material out of which we build an abundant life. Now I'm talking about a life of real abundance, a life that is full, a life that is meaningful. That is the job we're all undertaking right now. We are all doing that. We are working to build an abundant life. And like with any building project, it takes planning. It takes patience. It takes hard work. And it takes the right material. It's up to us to choose. Just as we choose when we're building a home, which materials we will use. I'm always impressed when someone I know takes on this job of building a home for themselves. Something I've never done. I'm not sure that I have it in me. It requires so many decisions, so much work. You have to buy the property you're going to build the house on. You have to contract with a contractor and get an architect. You have to make thousands of decisions, including on which materials you will use in the home. I read a book this week that I thought was fascinating. It was about 10 materials that we take for granted in this world. 10 materials that make up what we think is so important in our daily lives, and we don't really think about them. One of the chapters in that book was about concrete. Concrete, it's used in almost every building that we build today. From skyscrapers and homes to dams and bridges, concrete is something that is absolutely necessary for our society, our civilization, to work as it should. Concrete is not something we think about building our entire house out of, but actually that's becoming more and more popular. People building concrete homes. Think of that. Not just a concrete foundation, concrete walls, concrete roofs. It's very popular in places that have natural disasters, where your home may face a hurricane, or a tornado, or a fire, or even a mudslide. These concrete homes are very resilient. In fact, the largest unreinforced concrete dome in the world, a dome over a building, it's 140 feet in diameter. Think of that, a dome made of concrete, 140 feet in diameter, and it has been in Rome for 2,000 years. That is strong material. That is resilient material. No wonder people are coming around to building their homes out of this material. We may not be undertaking the project of building a home, big project, and certainly not a concrete home, but as I said earlier, we are busy right now building abundant lives. And we choose what we are to build those lives out of. We can make wise choices. We can build out of something that is lasting, something that is strong, or we can choose something weak that maybe looks really good, but it's not something to build an abundant life out of. Now, there are lots of materials that make up our lives. You know, just as if you were going to build a concrete home, you wouldn't have a concrete bathtub. You wouldn't have concrete doors. You wouldn't have concrete shelves. Even in a concrete home, there are lots of different materials. Well, so it is with life. We build our lives out of many things, including our work, our accomplishments, our education, our home, our health, our travel, our worship life, our prayer life, our life of service to others. All of these materials we use to build an abundant life. But what ties all these materials together? What is the thing that the foundation of our abundant lives is going to be built out of? The walls, the structure of that life. Well, love is what should tie a truly abundant life all together. It should be the number one building material of our lives. It's what our scripture says today. Love builds up. Building, as far as I know, always starts with the foundation. The foundation for us is God's love. God's love, serving as the foundation of our lives. The Bible says it simply, right? It's a great verse, nice and short, it's a good sentiment. God is love. God is love. And how much that means to us today means a lot, this foundation on which we can build our lives. First, we know that God created this world. God created this universe. And because God is love, we know that this world, this universe is good. It is friendly. We need not fear the parts of this world that might scare us a bit. Death. Death may scare us. But we need not fear death because God is love. And God, through His Son, Jesus Christ, has made it possible for us to overcome death, to be forgiven for sin. Now, we don't have to fear in this world as we look out. As dangerous as it is sometimes, as difficult as it becomes sometimes, we do not have to be afraid. For God's love, and God created it all. We do not have to fear what lies out there in the dark beyond, out in the recesses of this universe. We have no need to fear of that. Because God is love, and God created that too. That is the foundation on which we can start building our abundant lives. Simply this knowledge that God is love, and God created us all and everything. But that's not where the foundation starts. That just stops. It's just the first layer. The next layer is just as important. It has to do with you and me, that God is love. And so God loves you. And God loves me. God loves all of us. All of us. All His children. We are loved in this world. It isn't that God just loves His world. He loves His universe. He loves His nature. God loves each and every one of us. And surely this is one of the causes of so much misery in this life. Is the inability to accept this love of God. The inability to believe it. To believe that we are, each of us, loved just as God's children. That's probably where our gospel and our telling of the gospel falls short most often. We do not succeed in conveying this fact, this foundational truth, that God loves others just as they are. God loves them. Even with all our imperfections, God loves us. God cares for us. And you know, that love should cause us to do one thing first of all. And it's one thing that's going to trickle down and affect everything else in our lives. Because God loves us, we can love ourselves. Because God created us. We are beautiful to God. Even in all our imperfections, God cares for us. And that's one of the messages for us today. It's one of the things hard to convince people of. It's one mistake we often make in our belief, in our faith, that God's love is not conditional. We often think that God would love me if I would straighten out my act, if I do, you know, do things a little bit better in my life, if I pray a little bit more, come to church more often, or if I wouldn't do this or wouldn't do that, then God would love me. And of course, then we fail at doing these things. We do not manage to change ourselves, and so we believe, oh, well, then God cannot love me. We believe that God's love is conditional, and we get that from this world. Because in our world, so many of our relationships are conditional. People give us their respect, they give us their regard, they give us their love, as long as we're fulfilling their needs. And when we stop, then that love seems to be taken away. How important it is for us as human beings to know we are loved unconditionally. How important it is for us to have this in our lives, in our hearts. What a blessing it is for us to know that there are people in our lives who love us unconditionally. That is a wonderful blessing. I tell you, unconditional love. You forget your burglar alarms, forget your pig-proof locks, forget your security cameras. Real security in life, real security comes from knowing that we are loved no matter what. And it doesn't matter if we come from a huge family and a great circle of friends, or we're in a very small group, because God loves all of us. And that love is absolutely unconditional. There is nothing we can do to keep God from loving us. It is God's nature. How important it is for you and for me to know this and to believe it and to carry it in our hearts. It is the foundation of then the life we build. The abundant life we can build right on that foundation. And we build that with others. And you know what? This abundant love, this unconditional love, because of it, it can have an effect on everything we build. Because we're going to carry this abundant love with us now into all of our relationships. And it's going to release us from the prison, from the tyranny of loving others conditionally. Because God loves us just as we are, we can love others. We can see other people, not as people that are, we don't approve of, we don't like. We look at any person and say, that is a child of God. And that is how we build an abundant life today. You know, it's about building others up. It's about community. It's about coming together as we do here in this church and as we do it among our families and with our friends to share this kind of non-judgmental love. To let people know that they are loved no matter what. It's wonderful. You know, we are building abundant lives together individually, but we are also building it together as a community in our neighborhoods, certainly in our church, in our families. We are building up abundant communities, and we're doing it with this kind of love. As Ellie said in our communion meditation today. As the Bible teaches us about what it means to be in community, about what it takes to be in community, it's always about love. Jesus said, I give you a new command. Tough one. Hard command. That you love each other even as much as I have loved you. That is what we are to reach for. The Apostle Paul, when he wrote to the Corinthian churches, as our scripture reading today had it, later in that book, he says, if you have the gift of prophecy, if you can fathom all knowledge, and if you have faith that can move mountains, but you do not have love, then you are nothing. If you give away all your possessions, if you give your life over to hardship, and you do not have love, you gain nothing. It's how we build an abundant life. It's how we build an abundant church. It's how we build an abundant neighborhood. Abundant, true abundance, is abundance of love. And it's this kind of love, this kind of non-judgmental love. Looking at each other and seeing children of God. And so it's something we can build today. How do we do it? How do we build an abundant life? What material do we use? Start with the foundation that God is love. Know that here in this world, that God has created it. And so it is good world. It is a good world. And there we do not need to fear being here. Know and believe that God loves you. Just as you are. Right now, in this moment, with all the mistakes behind you, with all the regrets, with all the guilt you may still carry, God loves you as his child. He loves you so much that he sent his son here to demonstrate that love, to preach about that love, and to die on the cross, which would ultimately defeat death and sin and bring us back into loving relationship with him and help us even more to grab on to this abundant life he has for us. We build this abundant life by looking and accepting one another for who we are, letting go of the expectation that, yes, I will give my love to this person. I will show Christian love to this person when they do this and this and this. And give that away, and we love as God loves, just the way we are. That is how we build a truly abundant life that rejoices in the knowledge of this great love. I remember when my children were little, and I always loved to take them swimming during the summer. And we'd go swimming, and I liked to teach them. I got to teach them how to swim. And it was always a lot of fun to go. And I remember when they were little, I would get into the pool, and then I'd take them in my arms. And I would carry them out into the deep part of the pool, just where the water was about up to here, where my shoulders and my arms were just above the water. And they would cling on to me, hold on to me at first, because they knew they were in over their heads. But they knew that even though I could stand up there, they could not. And so they were scared at first, but eventually they would let go. And it was so much fun. I remember so well how they would swim around me like little fish. And they'd swim, and I'd throw them up in the air, and we'd play games together. But mostly it was just them swimming around, learning to swim, getting stronger in their swimming. And when they got tired, hold out my arms, and they'd come and they would hold on to my arms. And then they got, when they were pressed, they'd swim some more. Sometimes they'd crawl up on my neck and my shoulders. And then I remember after a long time, we'd stay out there a long time, they would be tired, but they could barely keep swimming anymore. And I would hold on my arms, and they would swim to me, and I would grab them in my arms once again. And then I'd take them back to the side of the pool and let them climb up the ladder. Well, how strongly it comes to me right now that as my children were to me in that moment, so are we always to God. The waters, they get turbulent. We certainly are in over our heads much of the time, but God is always there, ready to enfold us in his arms, ready to keep us safe and to allow us to rest in the security of his love. So when the testing moments of life do come, when the clouds gather, when the water becomes turbulent, we can feel that God's arms are all about us as his love surrounds us. The love that we can then use to create and to experience a truly abundant life. Let us bow in prayer. Loving God, we do give thanks for your great love, which can serve as the foundation of our lives, which can help us knowing each day that we live in your care and that we are loved by you come what may. Then God, help us to take that love and to build wonderful relationships with it, to share that love with others in an unconditional way. God, help us to feel that love in our hearts each day and share it as much as we can. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. If you were looking for a church home today,